Hey, I'm Andy Olidort, and in this edition of History of Rock, we're going to take a look at that most peculiar phenomenon known as surf music. Surf music exploded in 1961 and rode a wave of popularity until 1964, and was inspired by Southern California beach culture. There are two types of surf music, instrumental surf and vocal surf. In this edition of History of Rock, we will focus on instrumental surf music, which was all about aggressive, reverb-drenched guitars and exploding sounds. Let's go surfing! Dick Dale, whose real name is Richard Mansour, is recognized as the king of surf guitar. He is of Lebanese and Polish Belarusian descent, and his first hit was this song from 1961, Let's Go Trippin'. Dick Dale's 1962 hit Miserlou is a masterclass in surf guitar playing, exemplified by fast tremolo picking a la the Greek bouzouki or the oud. This song was immortalized in Quentin Tarantino's film Pulp Fiction. Wipeout by the Safaris from 1963 is the most famous surf tune of all. All bands in the 1960s had to learn it, and the drum solo was a prerequisite for any drummer to get a gig. Another essential surf hit is Pipeline by the Shantays, also released in 1963.
Everybody's heard about the bird.
And no investigation of surf music would be complete without mentioning the completely bizarre Surf and Bird, released in 1964 by the Trashmen. Vo local surf music is exemplified by such recordings as Surfin' USA by the Beach Boys, Surfer Girl by the Beach Boys, and Surf City by Jan and Dean. By the mid to late 60s, surf music was a thing of the past. As Jimi Hendrix says on Third Stone from the Sun, and you'll never hear surf music again. For History of Rock, this is Andy Allador.